Hey guys, it's Michael. The IRS just gave us our final warning. They basically said, look, if you filled out this form by this date, you'll get your stimulus check soon. If you don't, well, you're gonna have to wait a couple weeks, maybe a couple months before you get your stimulus check. And I wanna make sure that each one of you guys get your stimulus check soon. So if you have not yet received your stimulus check, well then this video is for you. Today I'm gonna be breaking down two recent IRS updates that came out earlier today that go over information for filers, non-filers, benefit recipients, and then at the end of the video, I'm gonna go over what you need to do and what the deadline is. So make sure you watch until the very end. Anyways, before we get started, it says that 95% of you watching this video are not subscribed to my channel. So if you'd like to stay up to date on the stimulus checks, on the stock market, on how to make money in general, then please be sure to subscribe to my channel so you can be notified when new videos come out. So before we get into the deadline and what you have to do in order to satisfy this deadline, make sure you receive your stimulus check soon. I'm first gonna go into a couple of other pieces of information on the updates. So the first update on the IRS press release is for non-filers. And according to the IRS, they said that non-filers tool is still available. They said this tool provides free and easy option for those who do not receive Social Security retirement, survivors, disability benefits, as well as railroad retirement benefits and VA benefits. So they said you should not be using the non-filers tool if you receive benefits of any kind. The non-filers tool is simply for people who make $12,200 a year or less individually or $24,400 a year or less as a married couple, not for anyone else. Moving on is for benefit recipients. There's an update for benefit recipients, and it goes over how automatic payments will be sent to those of you receiving Social Security retirement, disability, and survivors benefits, as well as railroad and VA benefits. So if you receive any sort of benefits, they said they'll be sent to you automatically. The only case scenario where you would need to use the non-filers tool is if you have a dependent. So if you receive any benefits, you do not have to do anything. You don't have to use the non-filers tool. You don't have to submit your information anywhere. They will automatically send it to you. So for those of you who have been asking me, what do you need to do? Basically, the IRS is saying you don't have to do anything. You just have to wait until they automatically get their payment out to you. Next up is for the filers. And in this update, it says that if you're an eligible taxpayer who filed your tax returns in 2019 or 2018, you will receive your stimulus checks automatically. They say you don't have to do anything. However, if you're set up for checks in the mail and not direct deposit, they want you to go ahead and use the Get My Payment tool so you can get your stimulus check via direct deposit. So you don't have to do anything, but if you want to get it faster, make sure to use the Get My Payment tool to input your information for a direct deposit. Next up, on the IRS press release, it gives us a couple of reminders of what we need to do. The first one is that to only check the Get My Payment tool once a day. They say if you try and check it more than once a day, you could lock yourself out. And they said it's basically useless to check it more than once a day because they only update it once every 24 hours. A lot of us already know this, but make sure to only check once every 24 hours. And then the next reminder is they said to be aware for scams. They said if you receive emails or phone calls from the IRS, don't answer them, don't respond, don't give any of your information to them because the IRS won't be contacting you this way. The IRS says that they will not send unsolicited electronic communications asking people to open attachments, visit a website, or share personal or financial information. So they're not really gonna be reaching out to you at all unless they're sending you your actual stimulus check. So if anyone contacts you for any reason saying that you need to provide them your information in order to receive your stimulus check, that's a scam, don't respond to it. So now let's get into the last warning that the IRS just announced earlier today. So they first started off by saying that there have been 130 million stimulus checks been already sent out. They said within the first 4 weeks of the program running. I think it's been more than 4 weeks, but I guess according to them, it's only been 4 weeks so far. And they said that a total of $200 billion has been sent out in these first 4 weeks. So that's good news. They said a total of 150 million stimulus checks need to be sent out in total. The IRS said that our last chance to receive a direct deposit stimulus check payment is coming up very soon. They said that people should go ahead and visit the Get My Payment tool on irs.gov by noon on May 13th. They said that noon, May 13th is the last day that you can go ahead and input your direct deposit information on the Get My Payment tool. They said if you do this before, well, then you'll be able to get a direct deposit stimulus payment. And that afternoon on Wednesday, May 13th, that the IRS will begin preparing millions of files to send through the Bureau of Fiscal Services for paper checks that will begin arriving late May and into June. So that sounds like that they haven't really even started sending out paper stimulus checks, because they said they're going to be preparing millions of files. So they've been saying that they've sent out paper stimulus checks, but according to this, it says that after noon on Wednesday, the IRS will begin preparing millions of files to send to BFS for paper checks. So it sounds like they haven't really sent these out yet. So you need to make sure to go ahead and use the Get My Payment tool and input your direct deposit information, because if not, it looks like they're gonna be sending out checks, and it looks like they haven't really done much with that anyways. And according to the IRS, they only can send out 5 million paper stimulus checks per week. So if they have millions and millions left to send out, well, you're gonna be waiting a while. So make sure to go use this before May 13th on Wednesday. There's one thing that I really want to clear up though, is that a lot of you have been saying, Michael, I'm getting my stimulus check now on May 13th. No, this isn't what the May 13th deadline is. The Wednesday, May 13th deadline is for you to use the Get My Payment tool to then get a direct deposit. It doesn't mean that you will be receiving your stimulus check or stimulus payment. It doesn't mean you'll be receiving it on May 13th. It simply means that that is the deadline for when you can submit your direct deposit information. So for all of you who have been telling me that you're going to be getting yours on May 13th and how there was an update earlier this morning, that is not what this update means. This update is simply a deadline for when you can use the Get My Payment tool. So according to the IRS commissioner, his name is Chuck Reddick, he says that we're working hard to get more payments quickly to taxpayers. He doesn't really say anything about benefit recipients and non-filers, but I assume he means that they're just trying to get payments out to everyone quickly. They're trying to get out as many as they can. They said that we want people to visit the Get My Payment tool before the noon on Wednesday, May 13th, which is the deadline. So this sounds like it's a very strict deadline. It's a very hard deadline. So make sure you use the Get My Payment tool to input your direct deposit information before May 13th. This sounds like it is their last warning before you're going to run out of time and you're going to have to wait for a paper stimulus check, which can take weeks. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to get your two free stocks valued up to $1,400 when you download the Webull Investing app. All you have to do is download the app, deposit $100 into your account, and you'll get two free stocks valued up to $1,400. It's a great trading platform. I trade all of my stocks on there, and who can beat two free stocks valued up to $1,400? Also, get one free stock when you sign up for Robinhood. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like the video down below, leave a comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.